In this video, I am going to discuss about cognitive field theories and its classroom applications. Cognitive field theories. This is a theory which proved because of the dissatisfaction with the approach of behaviorists. The cognitive psychologists try to see learning as more deliberate and conscious effect of the individual rather than the product of mere habit formation or stimulus response mechanism. According to them, in a learning process, the learner does not merely receive or make response to the stimuli, but definitely process, that is, interacts with and does something about what he receives, and his response is determined by the processing. They believe learning are critical of not mechanical association. They emphasize phenomenon of perception and organization. Internal mental process and cognitive structure and formulating cognitive patterns which man might acquire from the past experience as a basis of learning. Cognitive field theories examines patterns of interaction between the individual and the environment. W. Kohler's gestures inside learning theory, Kurt Lewin's topological learning theory, Edward C. Tolman's sign gestured learning theory, and Asperger's theory of verbal learning are under these perspectives. W. Kohler's gestures inside learning theory. Gestalt is a German word which means pattern, form or configuration. These psychologists believe that we react to our own pattern of perception when we face a problem. Among them, Wirth Gettmer, Kurt Kuffer and Roland Kofler emphasize more on the previous experience of the learners for developing insight and name the theory as insight learningful theory. Learning as a result of organization of perception by the learner. These psychologists believe learners perceive, think of a whole, not for a parts. They proved with experiments conducted in the chimpanzee. The theory of learning by insight is basically associated with the name of Ulfa Gongler, who conducted a series of experiments on chimpanzees. Some of these experiments are discussed below. Experiment 1. A chimpanzee was closed in a cage with a stick. Some bananas were put outside in the cage. Seeing the fruit, the chimpanzee became restless and tried to get it back. He failed in all his trials. Then he perceived the stick and the total situation. He got bananas by establishing the relationship between the stick and the banana. Experiment 2. In this experiment, two sticks were put in the cage. These sticks were such that they could be made big stick by inserting one in the other. The chimpanzee first tried to get bananas with one stick but failed. Then he inserted one stick into the other and got banana with the help of the big stick. Experiment 3. In the experiment, chimpanzee was put in the cage and bananas was hung by the ceiling of the cage. A box was also put in the cage. When chimpanzees could not reach bananas, he used the box to raise his height and got them. From these experiments, he proposed the laws as laws of figure ground, laws of pregnancy, laws of continuity, laws of similarity and laws of proximity. Kurt Lewin, topological learning theory. Lewin was also a gestalt psychologist. But the difference between Kohler and Lewin, the Kohler gave emphasis on previous experience of the learners for developing insight, while Lewin emphasizes more on the development of behavior and makes use of motivation. According to him, learning is behavior, a locomotion from one region of life space to the another. That is, when a person moves from one region to another, the structure of his space gets changed. This change in the cognitive structure is called learning. He classifies learning into four categories: change in cognitive structure, change in motivation, change in the acquisition of skills, and change in group belonging. He also proposed there are four main components of theory. Life space, it refers to the environment to which individual is living, responding or reacting. It includes features of the environment to which the reaction is made, the people to which the learner comes in contact, the problems he faces and the manipulates and the way he thinks. Vectors, it refers to the attraction or repulsion of the region. If the region of an activity is attractive, it is called positive valence. And if the goal is repulsive, it is called negative valence. Barrier. When individual undergoes the process of learning, he comes across a number of difficulties to reach his desired goal. These difficulties may be physical or psychological in nature. Motivation. Motivation is the process in which motives are related to specific goals and these motives are satisfied when the goals are achieved. These motivations may be internal and external both. He revealed, learning is not a haphazard and unplanned process according to him. It depends on how the life space is organized and how the psychological world is constructed while crossing the barrier. Edward Tolman signed gestalt learning theory. The important characteristics of his theory is that it has almost all the merits of response operant conditioning theories and field theories. He believes that learners do not respond to the stimulus, but they act on their own belief and steer toward goal by using their own intellect. He also says learning is an affair of science gestalt formation, refinement, selection, and intervention. He proved latent learning takes place as a result of exploration and acquire cognitive map while learning. He proved that with the experiment conducted with the group of rats. One of his experiments is known as latent learning experiment. This was conducted in 1930. In this experiment, he allowed a group of rats to run through the mazes without giving food. Later on, the food was given as a reward to them. The group of rats which was given chance to explore maze learning much faster than the group which could not find the maze. By this experiment, Tolman concluded that some latent learning took place as a result of exploration of the maze. Reward expectancy learning experiment was another experiment conducted by him. He selected a too hungry group of rats and trained them to find the reward in the form of corn. The matched group was called experimental group and the sunflower seed group was called control group. The experiment continued for 9 days and on the 10th day, these two groups were interchanged with the respond to reaction. It was found that experimental group which expect brain match committed more mistake than its counterpart of and its learning was disrupted. On the basis of this experiment, it is concluded that behavior is docile and hence can be molded by experience and training. Learning can be improved and errors can be reduced by providing rewards to the organism. Learning is an affair of science gestalt, formation, refinement, selection and invention. David P. Asbel's theory of verbal learning. The other name of this theory is theory of reception learning or theory of meaningful verbal learning. Asbel says if the learner has properly internalized the material learned, they can easily reproduce it. The more the material is presented to the learner systematically, the more the process of internalization will be facilitated. According to him, learning is internalized by using the following two processes: progressive differentiation process and integrative reconsolidation process. As a result of the reconsolidation, new learning takes place. This is known as integrative reconsolidation. In the words of Asbel, to facilitate learning and retention, it would be necessary to introduce appropriate submers and then the part of cognitive structures prior to the actual presentation of the task. Education implications of cognitive field theories. Small children are very much able to perceive essential relationship when they are given concrete material. At higher intellectual level, students are better able to perceive abstract materials. Past experience of the children and their background should be associated with the present situation to develop the insight in students. Learners' reasoning, thinking, imagination power, creative potential are always encouraged. Proper psychological as well as physical environment should be provided to the people in the class in order to help them across the barriers and develop inside them. Learning can be improved and errors can be reduced by providing rewards to the organism. Students may consult the following reference for further studies. Thank you.